Okay, good morning. So let's review the rectifier circuit. Okay, rectifier. How can I write the rectifier? Yeah, rectifier. I can write my rectifier like that, right? This is my rectifier. So my rectifier converts this AC signal into this DC signal, right? Something like that. This is AC. This is a not very good DC, but anyway, it is a DC. So it doesn't go to negative. So the simple thing is I have AC source here, VS. This is my AC. And then I have a diode and resistor here. That was the VO here. Now, if I have a VS is like amplitude is 10 volt, then my AS is something like that. I mean, this is my VO. Okay? So, say, how about this case? See, if I make change this resistor by a capacitor, okay, by a capacitor, then what happens? Say, I will apply same VS, and then because of a voltage drop, 0.7 volt here. Yeah, my output voltage will be something like it just go up and then stay at the 9.7 volt. Say, this diode charges this capacitor to 9.7 volt, and then diode is turned off. No current flows in, no change in capacitor voltage. However, see, yeah, in this case, this is reverse biased, right? However, at the next cycle, say, then, when it comes in, so it's 9.7 volts, right? Some current flows in, so it is charged up to like 9.8 volt, and next cycle 9.85, and eventually it will go up to 10 volt and stay there, right? Because diode has exponential IV characteristic. Okay, so it just goes to 10 volt and stay there.요거? 9.3이네. 예, you're right. 9.4. 9.45. 그래서 10볼트까지 간다는 거죠. 계속. 오케이. Then what happens if I put capacitor, resistor, and capacitor in parallel. Yeah, they are in parallel. So, see, this one, this is my VS. Starts 10 volt, minus 10 volt. Okay? And then, yeah, so, in this case, see, because when this becomes plus 10 volt, diode turns on, and then capacitor voltage will be charged to 9.3 volt, right? This diode turns on, some current flows in there, some current flows there, right? So this current will be 9.7 divided by R, and then some remaining current, I mean, out of this diode current, this much current flows through cap resistor. The remaining current flows through this capacitor. Okay, I mean, okay, this is resistor current. And then, yeah, my diode capacitor voltage rises 9.3 volt. Yeah, here, then this diode voltage becomes smaller than 0.7, right? This is because of Vs minus Vo. Yeah, in this reason, Vs minus Vo is smaller than negative, reverse bias. So diode is turned off. This capacitor charge will be discharged by this resistor current, right? Capacitor voltage is 9.3 volt. Then this is 9.3. 9.3, this resistance flows current. This current must come from the capacitor charge. So capacitor voltage will be reduced. So it's a discharge, right? Discharge. So it will be discharged, but like if this T, this one is T equals 0. Yeah, this capacitor voltage will follow exponential curve, right? Some sort of exponential curve. This is like 9.3 exponential minus T of RC. Okay? Yeah, this period T, this is 0. T is usually much smaller than this RC time constant. This R is just load, right? Load. So we increase this capacitor voltage. Sometimes we call this C a filter. If I increase this capacitor, I can satisfy this condition. T is just one period of 60 hertz sine wave input. Yeah, T is around 16.7 milliseconds, right? Yeah, see, the diode voltage is this voltage, right? This much voltage is diode voltage. Diode voltage is difference between Vs minus Vo. So diode voltage is negative here, right? Negative. So it is off. Yeah, this is very large negative there, right? So we'll get peak inverse voltage there, right? Peak inverse voltage. Yeah, at this time period, when the difference between this Vs and Vo becomes 0.7 volt, then diode turns on again. So we'll follow this one. So this is 9.3 volt again. Okay? And then discharges. So this is my ripple voltage. Okay? This is my ripple voltage. So, how can I calculate the ripple voltage? So I will approximate this one by a linear curve. Because my time t is much smaller than the time constant RC. So it's linear. This approximation is something like my resistor current is a constant, the same assumption, right? So if my resistor current is same, which is see, if my resistor current is like that, this is my resistor current, then it is a constant. Then see, this waveform will be linear in time, right? capacitors. So the amount of charge consumed supplied by capacitor should be this resistance current times this delta T is on time of this diode. Delta T is on time. But this on time usually is small. So this is R 9.3 times T, right? So I can calculate my ripple voltage easily. Peak voltage T of this RC time constant. So that's my ripple voltage, right? Yeah, peak inverse voltage. Yeah, this is around 9.3. This is around minus 10, right? So my peak inverse voltage, which is the maximum voltage, maximum reverse bias voltage of diode, 19.3. So I need to calculate the conduction angle. So what's the conduction angle? This one. So if I just move this equal T equal 0, and then see, I just assume this is cosine omega T. So my cosine omega minus delta T is what? Is this 9.3 minus ripple voltage plus 0.7, right? So the voltage here at the T equal minus delta T, the output voltage is 1.7 volt smaller than Vs, right? So this is only what? There must be 10. So this is 10 minus V ripple. So then I can calculate this thing. Yeah, that's cosine is a symmetric function minus omega delta T is the same as plus omega delta T 10 minus V ripple. Yeah, you can say this minus omega delta T equal arc cosine 10 minus V ripple over 10, right? Or, so I will use the Taylor series expansion. Yeah, this square. Square equal 10 minus VR. So, yeah, my omega delta T should be square root 2 V ripple divided by 10. Okay? Is it true? Yeah. I know my V ripple. V ripple is 2 watt peak voltage divided by T of RC, right? T of RC. Question.요거? 어디? 요거? 아, 갈로를 안 썼구나. 그렇게 해도 되고, 요렇게 해도 되고. 오케이? 네, 퀘스천. 무시했어. 그러니까 VR이 9.3보다 10%, 요거의 10%보다 작다고 무시했어. 오케이. Okay, let's continue. So, we talk about limiting circuit. This time we have some clamping circuit. What's a clamping circuit? So we have seen a similar circuit in the different order. Say, yeah, like that. This is a rectifier circuit, right? So, yeah, for this case, I know, say, this diode turns on whenever Vs is larger than Vo. Then, see, if this is 10 volt ampli sine wave with the amplitude of 10 volt, yeah, this will just stay at the 10 volt, right? 10 volt DC. Okay, Vo. Then, what's the voltage drop across there? This diode voltage. Yeah, this diode voltage is only Vs minus Vo, right? Vs minus Vo. Okay. So this voltage is, this is 10 sine omega t minus 10 volt DC. So this diode voltage only negative, right? Yeah, my diode voltage is 0 minus 20, right? That's my diode voltage, right? So in the diode voltage, one side, I mean, in this case, the maximum voltage is clamped. Maximum voltage is fixed at the zero. Okay, fixed at the zero. So yeah, so here, see, in this case, see, my diode is it the same? No, this diode is changed the direction, right? So if you compare this one, what? Actually, so this VI is a periodic. Clamping circuit works at the periodic. Yeah, this is my periodic. Is it? No. Periodic is something like that. Periodic. Periodic in time. Then one side, I mean, mean or max voltage is clamped set to zero. Okay? 0 volt. Yeah, this is AC. Actually, it is some waveform. Any waveform, periodic. Any periodic waveform like that. So this is a square wave, something like that. Yeah, this swing is a 10 volt swing, right? Then, assume initial voltage is, yeah, this is my initial voltage, right? My initial voltage is zero. Then, when this becomes negative, for example, in this case, minus 6 volt, right? Then diode will turn on, right? Because this is zero, then this diode voltage becomes 6 volt, right? So it will flow huge current very quickly, and then it will charge this capacitor into 3.3 volt very quickly, right? There is a 0.7 volt drop there. So 3.3 volt, minus 3.3 volt will be developed across capacitor very quickly. Next time it will change to 3.4 volt, 3.5 volt. Finally, this voltage will change to 4 volt. No, sorry, 6 volt. Sorry, this is 5.4. Okay, 6 volt. Okay. Because of periodic input, capacitor will be charged to 6 volt. Then after that, it never turns on. If capacitor voltage reaches 6 volt, this diode voltage is always negative. You can see what's this diode voltage. Yeah, that diode voltage is let's see. Yeah, my Vo, say I apply KVL. So this is a 6 plus Vi, right? What's 6 plus vi? It's just 0 and then 10, right? 0, 10. So it's always reverse biased. It never turns on, it never follows the current. Capacitor voltage doesn't change. Alright? So it is clamped to 0. Sometimes it's called DC restorer. So it generates the DC voltage, right? The average DC voltage becomes a 5 volt here. Okay, question? No? No question. So like this connection, VO is always positive. It is clamped at 0. So if I put resistor there, what happens? Say, yeah, see, without resistor, say, this is same waveform, plus 4, minus 6, okay? Then, without this resistor, no resistor, there will be 6 volt DC developed across the capacitor. But if I add this resistor, then see this diode is off. However, this RC, there will be RC discharge. See, for example, see, let's see. If this becomes 4 volt, when VI is 4 volt, then the resistor, let's see, this is 10 volt, right? The resistor voltage will be 10 volt, right? Yeah, diode is still off, but it will flow current through resistor, right? That current must come out of those capacitor, so capacitor voltage will be reduced. Yeah. So that's this one. Is this right? Yeah. There is a RC discharge here, right? RC discharge. Then, yeah, see, let's see. Then, see here, this VS suddenly change to minus 6 volt. Yeah, here, minus 6 volt. What happens? Let's see. Yeah, for example, I will assume this is minus 10 volt, right? For example, this capacitor voltage will be reduced to 5 volt, okay, at this time point. Then, see, this is 9 volt, right? Because the voltage VO across diode, because this is only 5 volt and this is 4 volt, so it's a 9 volt there, right? So capacitor at this time point, the capacitor voltage is 5 volt. Yeah, although there is a sudden change in VS, capacitor voltage cannot change instantaneously, right? So it just remains at the 5 volt after this transition. Then what's VO? See, this is a 5 volt, this is a minus 6 volt, so this voltage will be reduced down to minus 1 volt, right? This must be 10 volt swing. Because this is a 10 volt swing, right? Minus 10 volt swing there. Capacitor voltage is continuous with the time. So there will be 10 volt drop here. Then, this diode voltage becomes forward biased, right? 1 volt. So there is a huge current flows through diode. And then, it will increase this voltage, like this is 0.7. So this voltage, so let's see, if this is 0.7, what's this capacitor voltage? Minus 0.7 plus 6, right? Minus 0.7, 5.3. Yeah, so this diode voltage, I mean this output voltage will be changed very quickly, very quickly. I think if I enlarge this part, so 9 volt and then minus 10 volt, minus 1 volt here, and then it will go very quickly to minus 0.7 volt, okay? Minus 0.7 volt. Then, after that, what happens? After that, this diode does not flow much current. Then, see, there will be this RC discharge again. Actually, diode flows current until it reaches 0.5 volt. So there will be some, this diode voltage will be reduced to 0.5 volt. After that, we can consider diode is turned off. Okay? Diode current becomes negligible if diode voltage is smaller than 0.5 volt. So assume it's off. Then again, if this is, we have RC discharge circuit, right? So then, because of this RC discharge, it will try to go to zero. Resistor voltage will try to zero. But this time is not very, assume this T is smaller than RC, then it won't change too much. Maybe I can say this reduced to 0.4, minus 0.4 volt, okay? Then this changes up to back to plus 10 volt again, then it will be, it will increase to 10 volt there, right? Then what's this thing? 10 volt, this is 9.6 volt, right? Then it will reduce to this 9 volt by RC discharge. Question? Huh? 0.5V가 그게 보통 PN 장션 다이오드 IV 특성이 이게 워낙은 익스포네셜인데 우리가 보통 미리암페어 스케일 보면 이쪽은 거의 지로고 그래서 이걸 내가 봤더니 0.5V 부분에 전류가 거의 제로가 된다. 거의 제로. Almost. Approximation이죠. 0.7V일 때는 꽤 많이 흐른다. 꽤 많이 흐르고 0.7V일 때는, 그죠? 우리 심플 모델은 그냥 이거죠. 이 모델에 있으면 0.7V에 머물러 있어야 돼. 0.7V부터 이렇게 반변이 시작돼야 돼요. 근데 뭐 리얼리스티가 뭐 0.5V쯤 가면은 전류가 거의 끊어져 버린다. 저항 전류보다 다이오드 전류가 작아진다는 거지. 오케이. Any other question? Nope. Yeah, so this is actually the plot of this is some diode model. This is ID. This is 15 milliamp, right? So this is zero diode voltage is 0.4 volt, 0.5 volt, 0.6 volt. So 0.6 volt is what? It's around 13 milliamp, right? 13 milliamp at the 0.6 volt. In a 0.5 volt, what's this thing? This is around 0.4 milliamp, right? We assume this is almost zero. 0.7 volt, I think it will be pretty large, very large. Larger than 100 milliamp, okay? It's less than 1%. The current at the 0.5 volt is smaller than 1% of current at the 0.7 volt. Question? No? Yeah, we just put You can see this is a clamp circuit, and this is a rectifier circuit. Rectifier. So for simplicity, we just cut, divide it. So assume there is no rectifier circuit connected here. And then what's VO1 of this clamp circuit? Negative voltage, right? So when this diode turns on, so this is some, this time this is just AC periodic. So when this voltage becomes positive, yeah, diode turns on, so it will charge this capacitor voltage up to 10 volt, right? Then my VO1, if I use that KVL to find the VO1, minus 10 plus VS1, right? This is minus 10 plus this 10 sine omega t. So it is negative, right? It swings between 0 and the minus 20 volt. Okay? If I apply this VO1 to this rectifier, this diode turns on when VO1 is negative, right? So it will be charged to 20 volt DC. So my VO2 is minus 20 volt DC. There, right? So actually, because of this swing, the swing is 20 volt, right? Anyway, I increased this voltage amplitude, the voltage amplitude 10 volt here. Then I got 20 volt DC. It's called voltage doubler. Yeah, spy simulation. This is VO2, right? DC. DC. Slightly smaller than that. Because of, so it will take time to go to minus 20 volt. Here is, it may be what? Oh, this is only 5 volt. Eh? Amplitude is 5 volt. You can see this is 10 node sine 0. This is 05 sine 2 pi 60 hertz, right? 0 offset 5 amplitude. This is the frequency. So here it may be around 4.5. Is this 9 volt? Maybe 9 volt. Some diode voltage drop, right? Yeah. Diode voltage drop 0.5, 0.5. So it's around 9 volt, yeah. So it will go to minus 10 volt eventually. If you simulate it. Is it positive? Yeah, it's positive. Okay. Positive. Oh, no, it's negative. Sorry. Negative. Okay, question. This time I added more. Say, for this part, yeah, this is a clamping circuit. I know what clamping circuit is. So my VO1 should be, this is 10 sine omega t. My VO1 should be positive, right? My VO1 should be, this diode will charge this capacitor to 10 volt DC there, right? So my VO1 is plus 10 plus VS, right? So plus 10 plus VS. This is my VO1. Then, what will be this capacitor voltage? See, next thing is I just added rectifier, right? So the voltage across this rectifier input is positive because it swings between 0 and plus 20, right? This positive voltage. And then when this voltage across this diode becomes 20 volt, it will flow current into this capacitor. This capacitor voltage will be charged to 20 volt DC, right? 20 volt DC. If I keep on charging, so charging, and then VO2 will become the 20 volt DC. Then I have a clamping circuit again. Then I need a VO1 minus VO2 for this input of this second clamping circuit. What's VO1 minus VO2? Yeah, that's 10 sine omega t minus 20. 10, right? So this is minus 20 to 0. So it swings between minus 20 volt and 0 volt, right? It is negative. Yeah, because the voltage between drop VO1 minus VO2 is negative, right? It is, right? Yeah, negative. So this node is more positive than at the 20 volt, this diode turns on, will charge this capacitor into 20 volt DC, right? This is 10 volt, this is 20 volt, 20 volt. Is this 20 volt? Yeah, 20 volt DC. Okay. Then, after this clamp circuit, I have another rectifier circuit, right? So the input to rectifier circuit is VO3. Oh, did I write VO3? What's VO3? VO3 is just 30 volt DC, right? VO3 to ground is, oh no, 30 volt plus 10 sine omega t. What's this? Yeah, it swings between 20 volt and 40 volt. Okay? 20 and 40 volt. Okay, so the input to the second rectifier is VO3 minus VO2. What's VO2? That's DC. 10 plus 10 sine omega t, right? Yeah, then this is only 0 to 20, right? Plus 20. So then, yeah, when this voltage becomes 20 volt, this will charge this capacitor into 20 volt DC, right? So what's this output? Yeah, 40 volt DC. So because amplitude is only 10 volt, my output is 40 volt DC. So this is called voltage quadruple. Question.10볼트짜리를 4개 쓴다고? 배터리. 그러니까 우선은 지금 뭐라 그러노? 그러면 렉티파이어가 없어도 되잖아. 지금 그런 얘기를 하면 그지? 근데 우리가 available한 소스는 다 AC야, AC. 파워 서플라이가 60Hz AC로 들어오고 있어야. 거기서 이제 DC를 뽑아 쓰고 싶어. 그런데 전압은 높이고 싶거든. 근데 뭐 어떤 사람이 10볼트밖에 안 줬는데, 뭐 어떤 사람이 지금 220볼트를 줬다 그래. AC를 줬는데, 나는 DC로 지금 10만 볼트를 만들어야 되는데, 지금 가속기 하려고. 그럼 여기 220을 자꾸 이렇게 올려야겠죠. 220볼트 AC 가지고 렉티파이어도 있어야 되고, 그 자꾸만 올려야 돼. 오케이, okay, any other question? No? 오케이. Okay. 야, this is a different type of voltage multiplier. So it is we have a small DC input here, and I can generate a very large. How can I write a very large? Very large. Yeah, this cow goes to temple, right? That's a very special thing. Cow usually doesn't go to temple, right? Human people go to temple. So this is pretty large. It uses a charge pumping. So this is a charge pumping. This charge is a capacitor charge. We pump charge by switching. Okay. So here's for example, if this is a 10 volt. Say I think this say I connect this node into 10 volt DC and zero. So if this thing is connected to 10 volt, this one is connected to zero. Okay. So this is a 10, 0, 10, 0. This is a 10, 0, 10, 0, 10, 0, something like that. Okay, this is always connected to 0. Then this voltage will be 20 volt in this case, right? Because I have charged 10 volt here. Then after that, I will switch this one into zero. I change this thing into 0, 10, 0, 10, 0. Then, see, because this is a 0, yeah, it's a charged. Actually, this will lose some charge, some charge sharing. This can be 5 volt, so it's supplied to 10 volt again. And finally, I think it is 30 volt. For the binary, something like that. I think this can be 80 volt or something like that. So by switching the bottom node, it's called charge pumping. I can increase the DC voltage. Yeah, let's look at the principle one by one. Yeah, this is the first stage. The first stage, yes, in this case, my DC is only 5 volt. Assume my initial capacitor voltage is 0. Yeah, then, see, I connect this 5 volt. Okay. Then, yeah, this diode will turn on. It will charge this capacitor voltage into 4.3 volt, right? Because of periodic operation, after that, next cycle, it will go to 4.4, next cycle, 4.45, and then eventually it will go to 5 volt after many cycles, okay? So I assume, man 내버려 두마. 한참 시간이 있으면 가죠. 그러니까 지금 이걸 생각해 봐요. 스위칭을 안 하고 이렇게 만들어 놓으면 어떻게 될까? 5볼트가 돼요. 그러니까 이 전류를 생각해 보면은 요 V하고 요 VD하고 ID를 딱 생각해 보면은 VD는 5V 빼기 VO가 되죠. 그죠? 5V 빼기 VO. 그 처음에는 이 VO 입장이 T가 딱 되면은 그 처음에 이제 T equal 0일 때는 VO가 0이었다고 해요. 0 VO가. 그러다가 얘가 이렇게 탁 붙여버리면은 잽싸게 4.3V까지 탁 올라가 버리죠. 굉장히 빨리 올라가죠. 이렇게 이제 4.3V가 상당히 빨리 올라가요. 그러다가는 이제 어떠냐면 4.3V가 되면 요 전압이 0.7V가 되잖아요. 그러면 좀 천천히 올라가, 전류가 작게 올라가가지고. 그러면 얘 전압이 0.6V가 되면은 더 작게 올라가고, 슬로우비. 0.5V가 되면 뭐 별로 눈에도 안 띄게 올라가고. 그러다가 조금 더 올라가면 0.4V가 되면 진짜 땅에 붙어서 가고. 그 0.3V, 0.2V 되면 왜냐면 전류가 작으니까 아주 천천히 올라가겠죠. 그래서 하루쯤 지나서 보면은 5볼트가 있겠죠. 아니, 다이오드가 이상적이지 않아서 그런 게 아니고, 다이오드 전류를 말할 것 같으면은, 이제 요 시각하고 VD는 지금 어떻게 되냐면은, 저기 어떻게 되나, VO인가? VD는 VS 5V 빼기 VO인데, 이 VO로 말할 것 같으면은, 이 녀석이 C분의 1 인테그랄 T까지 ID, DT, 뭐, 이걸 합해 놓으면, 이 ID를 그림을 그려보면, ID 그림을 같은 플롯에 그린다면은, ID가 처음에는 폭발적으로 크다가, 작아졌다가, 이게 이제, 그러니까 자기 전압이 자꾸만 줄어들잖아. 이 VO가 이렇게, 전류가 자기를 집어넣으면 VO는 증가하고, VD는 감소하잖아요. 그제? 5V, 합쳐서 5V니까. 그러니까, 이 VD가 줄어드니까 이게 익스포넨셜하게 전류가 작아진다는 거죠. 그래서 보면은 전류가 작아지면은 VO가 올라가는 파형, 이 기울기, VO가 올라가는 기울기가 뭐냐 하면은 I 나누기 C죠. 그죠? 이게 슬로우업이 되잖아요. 그죠? I가, 이 VD가 작아지니까 ID가 작아지고 올라가는 슬로우업은 지수함수적으로 작아지고 그래서 굉장히 오래 걸린다는 거죠. 중간에 막 바뀌어버리면 올라가다 그만두고 있겠죠, 그죠? 한 0.5V 올라가서 그만두고 있을 거예요. 다음에 오면은 또 조금 더 올리고. 그런 식이죠. 근데 0이 되면은, 얘가, VO가 완전 5V가 되면은 VD가 0이 되죠. 그럼 이 전류도, 요, 참, 마이너스 1이 있으니까, 전류도 완전히 0이 되죠, 그죠? 그럼 거기는 안 변하죠, 이제. 전류가 안 들어오니까. 캐패시터를 누가 충전을 안 해주니까. 캐패시터 전압은 가만히 있죠. 예, 질문. 예. 그거 롱타임이 걸린대잖아. 그러니까, 자꾸만 팍팍. 빨리 들어올 때는 0.5V 이하는 다 끊어져서 내 무시해버렸다. 지금도 여기서 만약에 주기가 바뀌었으면은 뭐 이쯤에서 바뀌어버렸다. 장이는 한 0.5V 가고는 멈춰 있을 거예요. 빨리. 왜냐면 이 롱타임 스케일을 우리가 못 기다렸으니까. 그래서 그런 경우에는 0.5V가 컷오프 볼티지. 그러니까 오래 기다려두면은 참을성이 좀 있어가지고 실험을 여러분 한 시간도 안 하고서는 실험을 한 5시간 동안 쳐다보고 있는 거예요. 그럼 올라가겠죠. 시간이 많이 걸린다. 예. 여기는 저 누가 렉티파이어 들고 와가지고 원래 자기도 이거 배터리를 샀으면 몰라도. 그 보통은 교류에서 이미 누가 렉티파이 해줬겠죠. 그거 가지고 올리는 거야. 보통 우리가 교류에서 그 뽑아내죠. 파워 소스가. 이건 그러니까 어디 가가지고 6볼트 배터리나 누가 있어서 사왔다. 그럼 되겠죠. 근데 뭐 돈도 많이 들고 귀찮잖아. 60Hz에서 뽑아내는 게 편하죠. 보통은. 오케이. So eventually this capacitor voltage will charge to 5 volt, okay? Yeah, when switch is connected to 0, yeah, it will charge to here. Yeah, when the switch is connected to 5 volt DC again. Yeah, see, this is a 5 volt. Oh yeah, this is 5 volt ground, right? Then this node voltage here is 10 volt, right? This is up. Diode, so I can assume my diode is up. So diode current is 0. Then capacitor voltage doesn't change. Yeah, so the diode voltage is minus 5 volt, right? So it works. My assumption is correct. Then Yeah, so yeah, my VC1, so this bottom node voltage is connected. Yeah, bottom node. My VCA is what? This is my VCA. This is my VCB. No, VC1. Yeah, this node voltage changes into 10 volt and then 5 volt, right? Then this node voltage changes to 5 volt and 0. It corresponds to here. So,그것도 0이잖아. 그러니까 이쪽에 연결되면 VCA가 5V가 되는 거죠. 요 위로 탁 연결되면. 얘를 위로 탁 연결하면 얘는 10V로 이렇게 쳐 올라가고. 그래서 이걸, this is called charge pumping. So actually it didn't pump yet, so I need another capacitor. So it's a charge sharing and it will pump some of its charge, right? So this diode voltage reduced to maybe 2.5 volt or something like that, this charge. Next time it will be supplied to 5 volt again. And then next time, see if this is connected to, when this node is connected to this 5 volt DC, and this turns on, and then part of this charge is pumped into another capacitor. So it's called the charge pumping. Yeah, so let's look at the charge pumping. I have a series of two similar circuits, right? I have two rectifier circuits in series. Yeah, see? Yeah, this is a 5 volt DC. Actually, for example, my diode on voltage is 0 volt. Yeah, we assume the 0.7 volt. For simplicity, we assume this is 0 volt. So it is ideal diode. So I am assuming, for simplicity, I am assuming my diode voltage is ideal. Diode characteristic is ideal like that. On voltage is 0 volt, okay? Say, then, yeah, see, if you look at this switch, when VCA is connected to 5 volt DC, if this is 5 volt, this is 0 volt, right? When this switch is connected here, 0 volt, this switch is connected to 5 volt, okay? Yeah, yes. Let's start with this red combination first. Say, if this is 0 volt, then I will assume this is on, this is off. Okay? I will assume. Then, yeah, this capacitor will be charged to 5 volt, and this capacitor will be 0 volt. 0 volt. I'm assuming zero initial condition for two capacitors. Because see, this right-hand side diode is off, no current flows in, capacitor voltage of this right-hand side capacitor remains at zero. Then see, let's see, what's the current? Current must be flows in, that's okay. This ID will be positive. How about this VDD2, this diode voltage? Yeah, see, this is 5 volt, this capacitor voltage 0, so this is 5 volt, this is 5 volt. Yeah, it is 0, that's okay. It can be turned off because diode voltage is 0. Yeah, next time it changes to this combination. Okay? Then I will assume this diode is off, this diode is on. Alright? Yeah, because this is a 5 volt. Yeah, this diode is off. No current flows in. And then this is 5 volt, and I have some charge here. So I assume this is on. So it's something like that. Okay, initial charge is this is 5C there, minus 5C charge there. There is a zero charge there. Okay. Yeah, because I assume that this diode is on, then because this is a 5 volt DC, some of this 5C charge will flow into this capacitor. Okay. So there will be some plus Q2, minus Q2 will be developed there because of current flow, charge flow, okay, like that. So I have a charge flow around the circuit. So this 5C will be reduced to plus Q1, minus Q1 later on, okay? So this on voltage is zero, you know. Q1 plus Q2 should be 5C because charge must be conserved, right? Sum of charge must be same. And after that, because of I use a KVL, so this is a 5 volt, right? If I use a KVL, that 5 volt must be minus Q1 over C. That's a voltage drop across this capacitor. Plus Q2 over C, right? That should be 5 volt. So I have this equation, and I have another equation. So minus Q1 plus Q2 should be 5C again, right? Oh, then what's this? Oh, yeah, it's easy. If I subtract them together, I know my Q1 equals 0, my Q2 will be 5C. Okay? So Q1 is completely moved to Q2. So later on, my VC1 will be 0 volt. Oh, is this 0 volt? No, 5 volt. This capacitor charge is 0, right? So because the voltage drop across this lab capacitor is 0 volt, and this capacitor is 5 volt, so the final voltage of VC2 will be 5, VC1 will be 5 in this combination. Okay? 5, 5, 5, 5. This will be completely discharged. Next cycle, this will be charged to 5 volt again. Yeah, this remains at the 5 volt after this combination. After that, yeah, there will be some, let's just see, 5C, 5C result. Any questions until now? No? All right, let's review a little bit. Yeah, initially, capacitor voltage is 0. Yeah, when this becomes 0 volt and this becomes 5 volt, then this capacitor voltage, is it right? Yeah, the left capacitor is charged to 5 volt, this right capacitor remains at 0 in this combination. Yeah, if I switch this one into red thing, 5 and 0. What happens? Yeah, this capacitor charge 0, this capacitor charge becomes 5 volt, right? Yeah, we've shown it. Okay, next thing, I will repeat this procedure again. When this becomes 0, this becomes 5. What happens? Yeah, this thing is charged to 5 volt, this thing remains at the 5. Is it right? Yeah, five. Because in this combination, yeah, in this state, this is 5 volt, and this is zero, right? This is zero. In that combination, I will assume this is off, this is on, and this 5 volt will be charged to this left capacitor. Because this is off, it just remain at the 5 volt. Yeah, you know, because this is a 5 volt, and this capacitor voltage is 5 volt. My VC2 is 10 volt in this case, and then this is only 5 volt. So right hand side diode has a reverse voltage of -5 volt. It is off, right? Yeah. Question. No. Okay, let's continue one more time. So now let's review. Yeah, at this stage zero and five, the capacitor charge is both capacitor charged at 5 volt, right? So when this becomes zero and five, yeah, this voltage is 5 volt, and this voltage is also 5 volt, right? After that, I will switch this one into 5 volt and this one to zero. Yeah, what happens? So I will assume this is off, this is on. Then let's draw the equivalent circuit. So I have a 5 volt here, and then I have a diode here, and then I have a diode there, and then this is a zero. So it's connected, right? So I have a 5C there, -5C there, +5C there, -5C there. So it is on. So it is a 0 volt, okay? So this is a 5, this is a 10 volt, right? Initially, so it is turned off. So here, see, you can see, after this switching, just after this switching, what's my diode voltage here? Say, if I across this one, I have 5 volt, 10 volt, and then 5 volt. So this will be suddenly plus 5 volt, right? Just after switching. So huge current will flow. Huge current will flow in this direction, right? Then, yeah, much of this charge will move here. Then, see, it will change to Q1, finally, Q1, and then Q2, right? So, yeah, some of those charges should be 5C, 5C, right? 10C. Because, see, you can see, in this cassette, there is no current flow through capacitor, right? So, the total charge inside the cassette must be the same. They can move to other places, but the total sum must remain the same. That's this one. Then I will apply KVL. My KVL is 5 volt will be, say this is -Q1 of C. Diode voltage is 0 eventually. This diode voltage is +Q2 of C, right? Then say what? Q1, Q2 equal 10C, and -Q1 +Q2 will be 5C, right? Then, so if I subtract this one, my Q1 equal 2.5C, right? My Q2 will be 7.5C, okay? So my charge, this capacitor voltage will change to 7.5 volt. This capacitor voltage will change to 2.5 volt, right? If I keep on doing, this will go to 10 volt, right? For the first capacitor, it just repeats itself, 0 and 5, right? 0 and 5 volt. And then this thing, second capacitor, yeah, it starts from 0, 5, 7.5. I think next time it will move, it will add around 1.25, like 8.75 or something like that. It will just add just one half. Keep on going until 10 volt. Okay? Yeah, question? No? Yeah, in this way, you can see this changes just 0 and 5, right? This thing, yeah, it just changes 0, 5, 7.5, 8.75, whatever, until 10 volt, okay? So this will reach 10 volt anyway. This will reach something like, I think 15 volt or something like that. I'm not sure exactly, I think so, 20 volt. Okay, because this is 5 volt, right? 25 volt. This capacitor charge is 30 volt. This capacitor charge will be 40 volt. So this capacitor charge will reach 40 volt DC ground, okay? That's a Dixon charge pump circuit. Okay, question? No? Yeah, let's stop here.